Alright, Dylan, so what's going on today?
Go pick up a frame.
Yeah.
Motors.
So I was talking to your dad, and he said that I need to babysit you.
Yeah, I might need to stop by Walmart and get a pacifier or two.
He said that I need to watch you because you really don't know how to do nothing. Is that true?
Yeah, that's very true. Beginner in the game.
So you're telling me that you don't know how to do anything and I do have to babysit you?
Exactly right. Pete's day.
Because I thought that you grew up around all this stuff. I thought you grew up around it.
Yeah.
You basically know the fundamentals.
Yeah, but it's never got the interest to learn.
So you're not really interested in learning then?
No. It's just... Of course I am.
So how old are you, Dylan?
We'll be 17 in a couple months.
Oh, so you're not even 17 yet?
Nope.
We got a 65 Chevy truck, bud. You already saw the cab, right?
Yeah.
We got to put that cab on the frame. I don't know if we're going to do that today. And then we got to put the motor and transmission in the truck.
Right.
Do you see what I'm trying to say?
Right.
Now, I'm sure the guy doesn't have all the parts necessary. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's going to be a lot of jigsaw puzzle action going on. Do you understand what that means?
Yes, sir.
All right, what does that mean, Dylan? Go ahead.
That doesn't mean you can't just plug it in the wall and it's going to happen. You got to make it work.
That means that we're going to start doing something on it, all right? And what's going to happen? We're going to need a special bolt. So then we got to close the shop down to go get a bolt. Do you see what I'm saying? Then we're going to get back to the shop. And we're going to need some washers, or we're going to need a sensor, or we might need a motor mount because he bought the wrong motor mounts. All right? That's called the jigsaw, bud. Okay? You got the domino effect, you got the jigsaw.
That's right.
Okay, do you know what the domino effect is?
One thing after another?
One thing after another, dude. You start out with the scuff and paint job, and you end up restoring the whole fucking car, dude. So this is a good job for you to learn on, and get experience, okay?
Right.
Because what we're doing, we're putting the LS2 fuel injection Corvette drivetrain in it. I'm gonna be honest with you, Dylan. I think that you're gonna be a little bit more smarter than the rest of the clown acts I've had here.
Yeah.
Don't fucking make me look like a jack off, okay, dude?
That's right, I won't.
I really don't want to be getting pissed off at you, Dylan. All right, bud. I really don't want to.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can only do what you can only do, you know?
I guess. Oh, actually, the real situation is you can only do what my friend Pete tells you to do because it's my fucking shop.
There you go.
And I'm going to tell you something else. It's going to be done the right fucking way. And if you got situations or problems that arise, you don't fucking take it in your own hands. You come and get me, and then we take it from there.
Yeah, right.
I would rather you ask a million questions than do it wrong one time. Do you see what I'm saying?
You have to do the whole thing again.
And then have to fucking do it all over again on my fucking dime while you're at home playing Nintendo or whatever the hell you do, dude. And I'm working till midnight fixing your fuck up. Now we either work together or we don't fucking work at all.
That's right.
Do you think you're gonna be able to handle this job, Dylan?
Yeah. Don't see why not.
All right, bud. Let's go get this fucking truck. Frank. Okay, this is the truck that was brought over on a trailer in a bunch of pieces, and we're now at the owner's house picking up the frame. And we can't even turn the wheels because he doesn't have anything hooked up, ready to go on it. And it's starting to be a pain in the fucking ass. Basically, what we're going to do is we're going to take Ken's frame, we're going to take it to the shop, we're going to mount the body. We're going to mount the body on the frame. We're going to put the motor and transmission in. Let's go look at that motor. Let's check out the transmission. What do you think? It's a lot of work, Dylan.
Yeah, it is.
Get some ties out. Let's tie it down, bud. Do you know how to do that, Dylan? Okay, wrap it around the frame of it. The rear end, put one or two. You know how to tie a car down, bud. Okay?
You want two or one?
I want four.
There you go.
I don't want the frame bouncing off the trailer because you didn't do it right. Okay, what we got here is we got a 4L60E transmission. Is that right, Ken?
Sure.
Is that a brand new transmission being completely rebuilt? Or?
It's rebuilt.
That's a rebuilt transmission. What do we got over here, bud? What is this?
That's a 5.2 liter.
Okay, we got a 5.3 liter fuel injection. Is that a Corvette engine?
It is.
So how much horsepower are we putting out on it? Do you even know, Cam?
Stock was 327. They said it could push 400.
Okay, we got 400 horsepower coming out. And we're going to mount this motor and this transmission in that truck.
Is that correct?
Correct. All right, we got all the bushings and everything and motor mounts and... What all do we have here, bud, that we're taking with us? There's our torque converter. Go ahead and set that down. Get everything ready, and we're going to go empty the trailer. We're going to tie the truck down. We're going to put the trailer in front of your house, and we'll be back to get the motor trimmed. All right?
Yep.
Okay, so there you go. It's a drivetrain of Corvette, and I think it's going to be a nice drivetrain if we can ever get it in the truck. All right, let's get her tied down. We're going to drop it off in the front, dude. Hold on, bud, what do you do? There you go. Put it on this side. Look, on this side of the spring. No, take that, there you go. Underneath the brake line. Yeah, and then put another one in the same place and then tie it. There you go, and then put one or two in the, and then put two in the front. I better help you.
Okay, Dylan.
Watch, bud. Have you unloaded the truck before?
What?
I helped your dad load the truck up.
About 20 of them.
Well, there you go. You know how to do it. We got the frame finally unloaded. We got it loaded and finally unloaded over here at my friend P's shop. That was a all morning fiasco. And basically, this is what you're looking at. It's a truck frame. It's a 1965 Chevy truck frame. The owner went ahead and completely rebuilt all the front suspension, brand new. He, I don't know what he did to the fucking rear end, but there it is. I don't know if we put any lowering type suspension on it yet, but what we're going to do, the owner said that he cut the springs, the front springs, 1 inch. But actually what we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and build the truck up before, we're going to go ahead and build the truck up before we go ahead and lower it. That way we'll have a lot of the weight on it. If we look over here in this corner, here's our motor. Now this motor, we found out this is actually a truck engine. It's a 5.3 liter. Fuel injection with a Corvette intake. Okay, so and if you look right here, you can tell, anybody that knows these motors, you can tell by the coils, those are actually truck coils instead of a car coil. Okay, so that's one giveaway that it was a truck engine. And then, of course, on the back of the engine, it's stamped right in the engine that says 5.3. Now, it does have a Corvette-style water pump on it instead of the truck-style water pump. Why, I don't know, but, you know, that's the kicker. That's what we're talking about. This is a 99 to 2002 5.3 liter fuel injection LS1. So this is the early version. This is the first generation. And he claims, the owner claims, that this is all brand new, rebuilt, reconditioned, and should be a strong running engine. We went ahead and ordered all the stuff for it. We'll get that in about 3 weeks. And here's a good little fucking deal for everybody out there. When you're doing this type of conversion, you need to have a relocator adapter plate to relocate your motor mounts where they're supposed to be. If you can see the plate right here where the bolts are on the block, you can see that it's moved the motor mount forward. Okay, and I see that he already has some motor mounts mounted on there. But the problem that we do have is that this setup here on this thing, this is set up for the six-cylinder engine or what have you, the early 65 model. So we're gonna have to do some type of configuration there. Also on the transmission cross member, we're gonna have to do some configuration on that as well. And we'll have to either move it back or forward or whatever to get that to line up. But we won't do all that until we get the cab on it. And actually, that's what we're doing right fucking now. We're getting ready to paint the cab. When I say cab, I mean part of the cab. We're painting the firewall. So if you look right here, we've had Dylan, the new employee guy, the kid that wants to learn. He went ahead and wet sanded this all down. He went ahead and also fine tuned it up with the Evercoat, the polyester filler. He went ahead and filled in the pinholes. He block sanded that down. And then he finally went over it, wet sanded it one more time. And now we got sealer on it, and we're gonna go ahead and paint that white. We wanna go ahead and paint the firewall now before we put it on the truck, okay, before we put the truck on the frame, I might say, because then that way that'll be done and the firewall will be ready for installation of all the stuff that we want to put on it, okay, the aftermarket stuff that it's going to get. So if you're planning on doing a conversion like this, which is updating your truck, okay, this is a good example here. We have welded up all the holes, we've welded up all the factory openings. Okay, and the only thing that we kept was the wire harness hole that we're going to use, the brake booster, and the steering column. Everything else has been welded up and filled so we can start over. So let me get the firewall painted. We'll take a look at it. We'll see what it looks like. And it should come out really, really nice. I want to remind everybody out there, and you can go back in my videos on SWRNC if you're watching this on DIY Auto School. Check it out. And check out the videos when this truck first got here and see what kind of pile of shit it was when we first started on it. I'll have a link on this video that you can actually click on either down in the comment area or up in the description area. Click on that and watch that video and see what kind of pile of shit we actually started out with. And don't forget to watch all the other videos on it, the how-to videos of replacing the floor and everything else that we did to this fucking truck cab. Let me paint it and we'll be back to look at the firewall. And hopefully it's gonna be nice. Hopefully.
Adios, amigos.